Kia ora. No mai, haere mai. Welcome, everybody. Good afternoon, and happy Father's Day. Thank you so much for being here. Wonderful to see you all. Welcome on behalf of the Town Hall Organ Trust and Auckland Live to this, the third concert in the organ concert series for 2023. It seems like we have a pretty full house, so it's wonderful to see you all here. The concert is being live streamed by Auckland Live online, so hello if you're watching from some distant place. You're very welcome as well. Hope you enjoy this afternoon. My name is Nicholas Forbes. I'm one of the organ trustees on the Town Hall Organ Trust. Today, we welcome a duo who have just returned from a wonderful concert and recording tour of France and Japan, organist Dr. Kemp English and violinist Yuka Eguchi. You might remember Kemp's wonderful CDs, Storm and Norma, from the Dunedin Town Hall, from Norma there, and these will be for sale at the bottom of the stairs in the stalls foyer at the interval and afterwards. If you were at the NZSO concert last night, you'll recognise Yuka, who is the orchestra's assistant concertmaster, so it's been a busy weekend for her. Although these concerts are free, they do cost a lot to present. So, as always, your donations are very welcome, either in the buckets that will be there at the doors when you leave, or otherwise directly through the Trust's bank account, with details are on our website, aucklandorgan.org.nz. Thank you very much for your generosity. Finally, just a reminder to please turn off your phones. No recording or photography is permitted during this concert. And stand by now for a wonderful afternoon of music. It gives me great pleasure to introduce you, please, Kemp English.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed, and a very warm welcome to Auckland Town Hall. It's great to be back in this amazing building playing this fabulous organ. Isn't she amazing? What an organ, yeah. I've got to know this instrument quite well over the years. I was invited to play in 2012 and then was very fortunate to be invited back again in 2014 and then again in 2019. So this will be my fourth visit to the Auckland Town Hall playing this magnificent organ. And a big thanks to Kerry Stevens, to Nick Forbes, and to all the members of the Auckland Town Hall Organ Trust for helping to make these concerts possible. And, of course, a very big thank you to Auckland Live, who actually make all of this work, and they do an amazing job publicising this event. But the biggest thank you all for coming along this afternoon. It's great to have a full town hall. This organ is a real treasure for Auckland. It is really a jewel in the crown of this Auckland Town Hall. As I've said on previous occasions, it's just been me playing this organ. But this afternoon, as Nick mentioned, I have my partner along, Yuka Eguchi. And as he said, she is the assistant concertmaster of the New Zealand Symphony Orchestra. Yep, and she was down there last night playing with the symphony orchestra. So she's having a busy weekend, as Yuka. Now, Yuka and I have been playing together, both on and off the stage, for around about the last 3.5 years. And we've clocked up about over 50 concerts together, not only around New Zealand, but increasingly overseas. In fact, we've just come back from a 2-month trip playing in Europe and doing some recordings in Japan. So without further ado, could you please give a big, warm Auckland welcome to Yuka Eguchi. Thank you. She is absolutely delightful. I'm a very lucky man. The first piece that we're going to play together is by Alfred Schnittke. And Alfred Schnittke was a Russian composer. He composed lots of film music, but he was really good at composing pastiche. In other words, he could compose in a Baroque style, a classical style, a Romantic style, or a 20th century style. And indeed, sometimes he wrote compositions which amalgamated all of those styles together. And that began to be known as polystylism. But today we've got our roots firmly in the Baroque period. And this is his delightful suite in the old style. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
It's quite a quirky little piece, that, isn't it? Particularly the way it ends. Next up, we have a work by a friend of mine, the Dunedin composer Richard Madden. And I think Nick mentioned that it's the 20th anniversary since I recorded the first CD, called Storm and Norma CD, on the Dunedin Town Hall organ, which is called Norma, after one of the organ builders, Hill, Norman and Beard. That's 20 years ago. In November 2003, the first Storm and Norma was made, and then there were two other discs after that. And this is one of the pieces that appeared on that series of discs. Richard is a lovely guy, and he's known mainly for his choral compositions. He's worked with the Choir of St. Paul's Cathedral down in Dunedin. but he's also written a handful of organ works. Two notable ones, this tuba tune and also the Montpellier March. Now, forgive me if you've heard this story before, but last time I was here, which was 2019, I played the Montpellier March. And I felt very proud of myself because I'd played in Montpellier itself in the south of France, and I'd played Richard's Montpellier March. So I came back to New Zealand, back to Dunedin, and I said to Richard, I'm really glad that I could play your Montpellier March in Montpellier City in the south of France. And he said, oh, that composition was named after Montpellier Street in Dunedin. But there you go, you try your best. Anyhow, this is a tuba tune, and it works incredibly well here on the Town Hall organ because we have an amazing tuba mirabilist. It's unenclosed, so it makes a really big sound. So I hope you enjoyed Richard Madden's tuba tune in E flat.
Thank you.
So that's the second piece on the programme this afternoon by Mons Leidvin Tackle. Mons Leidvin Tackle is a Norwegian composer, and I've got to know him very well over the last 10 or 15 years. He's a lovely man, and as you can tell, he composes really beautiful music. And in the second half, we're going to be playing a new composition that he's written for us called The Palettes of Love. And hence the title of the program this afternoon, Celebrating the Old and the New. The old bit being a sort of anniversary of my Storm and Norma CDs, and the new bit being new compositions by Mons Leidvin Tackle. Just absolutely gorgeous melodies he writes. He's an amazing composer. Next up, we have something everybody will know, the Invercargill March, made famous by lots and lots of bands the world over. It's become one of the most popular marches in the world, up there with Sousa and Radetzky and all of those other marches. And I recorded that on Storm and Norma 2, I think it was. And the reviewer said, it's because I muck around with the tempos a little bit. So I kind of making it fun. And the reviewer said that it sounded as though it was the band in Invercargill marching down Tay Street, having visited too many pubs on their way. But anyhow, it's a great piece, and I hope you enjoy it. What a great march by Louis James Alfred Lefebvre Welly, who used to be the organist of Salle Peace in Paris. He loved to bring popular music of the time into a liturgical setting. And I wonder how the priests enjoyed such music after Sunday morning Mass. They must have danced down the aisles after Mass was over. Now for something completely different. This is a work by my friend Mons Leidvin Tackle, called The Palettes of Love, and I said earlier that he'd composed this work for us to play. Back in 2019, I went through some really heartbreaking times in my life, probably the most heartbreaking I've ever had. And Mons Leidvin knew about this, and he'd had similar experiences in his life, and he found out that I'd met the lovely Yuka, and she was a violinist. So he decided to write us a piece because we'd just got together, and it's a piece that explores all the emotions that go with rebuilding love once again after it's sort of disappeared in one form or other. And that's what this piece is about. It's about the palettes of love, the various different changes and things that we go through. So it can be quite challenging, particularly confusing love, number four. That is really quite wild. And some of the piece itself is quite wild because the emotions are quite wild too. But in the end, I Love You, movement number five, is a very, very beautiful piece, much like the Heart of Peace. And then it has the victory of love at the end. So love overcomes everything. And that is basically what this piece is all about. So we hope you enjoy it. This piece, this performance is the New Zealand premiere of this work. Earlier this year, in June, we gave the world premiere in Montpellier Cathedral in the south of France, and then we toured with it around Europe. And people seem to love it, despite its challenging moments, so we hope you love it too. So this is The Palettes of Love.
Thank you.
As you can see, it's quite a challenge for Yuka against this enormous instrument. But Tackle has written a truly superb piece, and we're very, very grateful to him. And I hope he'll write some more things for us too in the future. to end the concert, and before I announce the last piece, I'd just like to say what a wonderful audience you've been this afternoon. It's been an absolute pleasure for both of us to be here and to putting the organ through its paces and to putting Yuka through her paces too. the last piece, Yuka stands a lot of chance of being heard, which is good. It's a work by W.S. Lloyd Webber. And of course, you'll all know that W.S. Lloyd Webber's children were Julian and Andrew Lloyd Webber, now Lord Lloyd Webber, of the massive, massive fortune. But W.S. Lloyd Webber was a very fine composer, a very fine musician. And he worked as the organist and director of music at the Methodist Central Hall in London, which is opposite the Houses of Parliament. And it's got an enormous romantic organ, just like this one here in the English style. And Yuka and I were due to do a concert there way back in 2020, I think it was. But, of course, COVID scuppered all of that. But in the process, we learnt this piece because W.S. Lloyd Webber, of course, was the organist there, and he'd written this work for the big symphonic organ and solo violin. It's a beautiful, absolutely beautiful work. So we hope you enjoy this Benedictus by W.S. Lloyd Webber. We do have one more up our sleeve, and this is from one of the Storm and Norma CDs. It's the Radetzky March.